Thanks, gentlemen. Mr. Fulliger and the college leadership team, to the parents who are in attendance today to see their sons presented, welcome. To the staff who are present in this hall or back in the classroom, you are very welcome as well. Of course, we have Year 9s and Principal Award winners in the room with us today, and all other boys back in classrooms around Nudgee. Welcome to you. And finally, to all of the parents and friends who are online watching our college assembly, given the joy of technology. Welcome to everybody to our Week 6 college assembly. Across this morning, a number of items will celebrate achievement and make a statement about who we are as a college. In a moment, our prayer will focus on the great Australian, Mary MacKillop, St. Mary of the Cross, whose feast day was celebrated recently. We will recognise today long-serving staff, people who have taught in Catholic schools for 20 or 30 years, and we will honour and respect that achievement. We will hear, of course, from Mr. Fulliger after he gives out the Principal's Awards today for students from grade 6 to 12 who have shown great improvement between last semester's report and the one before. We look forward to a report about the recent boarding formal dinner. And we'll hear from one of our grade 12 boarders who sang a moving song in tribute to the late Julie Kapitke. And finally, we look forward to an interview where Captain of Boats Ben McMillan will interview this term's sports captains to give us an update, along with many other messages and items of importance. Thank you to everyone who is either present today or tuning in, and we look forward to a wonderful assembly. As always, we gather as a Catholic community, and so begin with prayer.
Thank you, Mr. Todd. Good morning, everyone. As we know, this year, 2020, has been a year of disruptions and adaptations, many of them on the run, and many of them have tested our flexibility and our adaptability. Two of the important celebrations that we've missed having together this year has been, first of all, our own patron saint, St. Joseph. In term one, we missed celebrating the Feast of St. Joseph together here in this room, and we had to celebrate that online. I hope many of you might remember that day. And then about 10 days ago, we missed the opportunity to celebrate Australia's patron saint, St. Mary of the Cross. Mary MacKillop, so far Australia's only saint, but I'm sure that is only a matter of time, given the candidates also being proposed for sainthood who are Australian, was a remarkable woman. She believed very clearly and very strongly that the way forward for Australia, still then really in its infancy in the 19th century, but the way forward for Australia to build a strong, robust community of justice and equality and fairness was through education. And that all Australians had to have the best possible, highest quality education they could possibly have. And if that meant that she and the women who gathered around her to form the Sisters of St. Joseph had to give of their lives freely so that even the poorest of the poor could have an education for free, then that is what they did. And they gave of themselves, they gave their entire lives in the service of God, in the footsteps of Jesus, and working with all and anyone who asked to come to their schools. And she is one of the many people, but one of the strongest examples of a young Australia forming itself based on values of fairness, justice, and equity. We speak a lot about a concept called resilience, and she would not have recognised that word in the way in which we use it. She would have thought of it more as an agricultural term, that a crop knocked by a heavy rain or a hard wind would be resilient in that it would bounce back. In her time, they did not use that word in the way that we use it. But she would have recognised qualities like boldness and audacity in the face of injustice and bullying, which she herself experienced. She would also recognise the quality of tenderness. She would have recognised the quality of gentleness to the students in her schools and the women who helped form her order. And she would have recognised a spirit of poverty, both in giving of her whole life to serve God, but in giving of herself to serve others, so that they may be wealthy, they may be rich, they may flourish. Not wealthy and rich in financial terms, but in life terms, flourishing with joy and with the love of God. Today we remember her, we celebrate her life and her gift to the church in Australia and to Australian society and to ourselves, that we may be like Mary and find God in all, in everyone, in our own lives. One of our long-serving staff who will be recognised today will lead us in prayer, and that is Mr. Anthony Canellum.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. With the bounty of the fig tree and the graciousness of the vines, with the yield of the olive and the abundance of the apple harvest, with the industry of the honeybees and the fatness of the cattle, with the sturdiness of the mountain and the agility of the gazelle, with the responsiveness of Mary and her creative imagination, bless us, live graciously with us, and hold us in your heart, living God. We make this prayer in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Live Jesus in our hearts.
Forever.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good morning, parents, students, and Nudgee staff. Can I just invite Mr. Fulger to come up on stage, please? Today, we acknowledge members of the college staff who have reached milestones in their service to Catholic education. We congratulate and thank them for their dedication to the vocation and teaching and working in Catholic schools. I'd like to call to the stage Mr. Chris Corley. Chris has spent 30 years in Catholic education, serving at St. Joseph's, Gregory Terrace, and of course, Nudgee College. In his absence, we'd also like to congratulate for 30 years of service, Mr. David Fletcher. Fletch, as we know him, has been at Nudgee College since 1988. Can we congratulate David and Chris, please? The following staff have dedicated 20 years of service to Catholic education. Firstly, Anthony Canellan. Anthony has served at King Cockle, Rose Bay, St. Iggy College in Riverview, and St. Joseph's Nudgee College. Susan Eldridge. Susan has been at Nudgee since 2001. Anthony Gibb. Mr. Gibb has been at St. Peter Claver College, Riverview, at Terrace, and at Nudgee College. And finally, Mr. Damien Rossetti. Damien has been at St. Augustine's Primary School, Mossman, Good Counsel Primary School, Innisfail, St. Francis Xavier, Primary School Cairns, St Michael's Primary School Gordonvale, RLHC Primary School in Cairns, and of course Nudgee College. Can we please congratulate all these staff?
Good morning, Mr. Fulliger. Families both online and here with us today, staff and also men of Nudgee. Today we celebrate the Principal's Award, and it's exactly what it says on the box. It's the captain's call. In this case, Mr. Fulliger's call. So with many of us involved in either a sport or a performing art this term, in what's most busy co-curricular term I've ever seen, let's use the context of our activities to think about what this award might mean for the people in front of me here. So we all sort of know, you know, of the top goal scorer or the best and fairest or the first board or the first violin. And we think about the awards those people typically get. And over the last few weeks, you've seen boys get gold, silver and bronze awards, or perhaps even a learning habits award. So we know about those, we know about the criteria. But the principal's award's slightly different. It's a bit like a coach's award or a mentor's award. Because the coach or the mentor knows, they see things that the spectator doesn't see, that the audience member doesn't see. They see the extra practice session. They see things like the hard work that boy's doing at training or being busy off the ball, making space, whatever it might be, whatever you do, there are lots of things that often go unnoticed. So today, Mr. Fulliger is recognising that true Nudgee spirit and perhaps some unrecognised talent, something that hasn't been recognised at Assembly so far today. So some efforts that we do make, boys, fall outside criteria that we can measure. And just because we can't measure them, it doesn't mean that they're any less important. So they're always, all the things that we do at Nudgee, even the things that people don't often see, are really valuable and make this community great. And the Principal's Award, I would have to say, is very hard to get. So we look at the improvement in grades from one semester to the next. So you'll notice there's no Year 5 boys today, because you weren't with us in Semester 2 last year, but perhaps Year 5, if you're watching in your classroom, you can think about being here next year. We also had a look at learning habits, and we looked at the improvement from one semester to the next, and we looked at what personal responsibility and self-agency those boys have taken here today. So have a think, boys, out there in your PC group or here today, Year 9, you know, how's my report card from last semester to this semester? How are my learning habits from last semester to this semester? Have they improved? That's what you need to be thinking about personally. Most importantly, though, once we work those things out, we send them to Mr. Fulliger. And he looks over them and he looks for the character of each boy. And he looks at those stories behind the things we can measure. The things he sees on a Saturday as he's walking around a field, the things he might see as he looks into a classroom. And so he tries to capture that essence of what a Nudgee boy is in the Principal's Award. So I'd like to invite Mr. Fulliger to the stage to present his awards, and also to our college captain in Jarrah Harbour, who'll be reading out the recipients' names.
In Year 6, the Principal Award recipients are Denver Bradford, Billy Grace, Alex Lamprecht, Nicholas Lamprecht, Isaac Michael, and Jake Stacey. Can we please congratulate our Year 6 medalists?
In Year 7, the principal award recipients are Angus Glyde, Hayden Hamilton, who is absent, Lachlan Highfield, Angus McLennan, and Hugo Timms. Can we please congratulate our Year 7 medalists? In Year 8, the principal award recipients are George Curry, Guillaume Lewin, and Oscar Shaw. Can we please congratulate our Year 8 medalists? In Year 9, the principal award recipients are Spencer Azlewood, Willem Makara, Joseph Rowland, Dean Scholes, and Emmanuel Taviri. Can we please congratulate our Year 9 medalists? In Year 10, the principal award recipients are Daniel Atkins, Dylan James Barawanga, Desmond Cowley, Harry Dixon, Callum O'Keefe, and Leo Swinton. Can we please congratulate our Year 10 medalist? In Year 11, the principal award recipients are Mason Davies, Jet Haber, Andrew Morton, who is absent, and Tehi Nicholson, who is also absent. Can we please congratulate our Year 11 medalist? In Year 12, the principal award recipients are Tristan Gill, Braithen Porter, and Adam Wilkie. Can we please congratulate our Year 12 Principal Award recipients and all students who receive Principal Award?
Thank you, parents, for joining us today. Welcome staff, of course. those staff and students who are here with us and staff and students who are spread around the campus as well. Particularly congratulations to the award winners, and great to have Year 9s here with us today who've been spectators like others across these first few weeks of the term. I'm always conscious when, I'm really pleased to give the Principal's Award today to you boys, but I'm always conscious that when we give out an award, I always think of those boys who don't get the awards. And over recent weeks, we've given out gold, silver and bronze awards. Today's Principal's Awards, amongst other things as well. Because while we need award winners, and we want to acknowledge boys, I'm really conscious that the school doesn't rely upon them. I'm conscious that when we give an award occasionally, and I think when we give an award, I'm trying to encourage those who receive the award and those who perhaps miss out as well. But I'm conscious that occasionally some boys see that as a bit of a disincentive. They see it as disencouragement because they've made an effort and hasn't been recognised. We can't always be recognised for our efforts, as good as they may be, because they're not always seen, as Mr. Sepetos referred to before. But nonetheless, the awards are given as an incentive to each and every one of you. And while we need award winners, the school isn't built, a great school isn't built on award winners. Just like as a school principal, I need teachers like those who are presented today to do their work. It doesn't rely upon me, one person. It relies upon the many teachers and staff who do their work. Just as we're having a great year in 2020, it doesn't rely on one boy like Injara as college captain. It relies upon every senior. It relies upon every boy across the school. It's across a depth of things. And for those people who have been at awards night over a few years, I basically put in one paragraph every year. And to be honest, it's a paragraph I've had in my awards night speech every year I've been a principal, because I truly, truly believe it. It's something that I base my sense of how we build a school on. And if I could, to paraphrase it a little bit, because it fits awards night, which is a little bit different to this morning, but it's something I say there. And it says, I have often said that great schools are built on the effort and attitude of our quiet achievers. And today is about the quiet achievers, not the gold medalists, the bronze medalists, the silver medalists. It's about quiet achievers. For every student who's been acknowledged today, or on the evenings of awards night, there are many other boys who have not received an award, but who have also done their best throughout the year. They've worked hard in their subjects, cooperated with their teachers and boarding supervisors, looked after their mates, worn their uniform proudly, been involved and passionate about their school. These boys may not be academic prize winners, but they strive daily to live our motto, Signum Fidei. And boys, the strength of Nudgee is on the collective of all of us, teachers and you as students, supported by parents. And not just on award winners, it requires every one of us. And when we gave the principal's award's been one that's been at the school for some time. It was several years ago, or past, when I talked with senior leaders of the college, that we decided to tweak it, because I felt we should recognise improvement. And those in learning and teaching have looked at those criteria, because I firmly believe improvement is absolutely fundamental to you as young men, but it's also fundamental to me as a person as well as it is to your parents. It's fundamental to life that we have to keep improving, and that the essence of improvement is learning, and that's why we are here. And to improve needs you to grow. To improve means requires you to change. It requires you to challenge yourself, as it is in learning as well. Because life is not static. Life keeps on moving. If Nudgee was we've been here 129 years, and if we were still the same as when the first boys arrived here in 1891, we wouldn't be much of a school. That's why the building projects that are going on at the school today are all about trying to improve the facility and amenity of the school. Have those people who have been in this school community for 129 have tried to do over all those years to try to improve and be better than they were last year. It's something I say to you many times as well. Now, that improvements can sometimes be a lot, and sometimes it can be a little. Sometimes it's going to get you an award and sometimes it won't. Sometimes that improvement is unseen by others and only from you. But sometimes improvement requires those qualities I've talked about, and Mr. Sepetos mentioned them as well, as did Mr. Mara in his introduction, about resilience, persistence, commitment. They're the three themes that I've wanted to have applied that view to remember through this term, this premiership quarter that we've talked about. Commitment, persistence, resilience. Three things amongst many other qualities that we need to be successful, amongst other qualities that require improvement. But I want you to be committed to improvement, boys. Not only those boys who are here in the hall, but every one of you who is sitting somewhere around the campus today listening. How can I be better today? Now, invariably, we as humans, we have a failing, of course, as we oftentimes compare ourselves to others. I do that as much as you do as well. But it's a dead end. When we compare ourselves to others, sometimes that'll make us feel good because we look a little bit better or can achieve a bit better than somebody else. So that makes me feel good. But you only have to look too far to find someone who's better than you. And that only, where does that end in? Well, I'm not as good as him, I'm not as good as her, and I'm not successful. There's only one person you need to compare yourself, boys, and that's with yourself. And your benchmark is who you were yesterday. And if you're a little bit better today than you were yesterday, well, good on you. Just like if we collectively are a little bit better than we were yesterday, we'll be a better school. And if we're a bit better collectively every day across a whole school year, then we'll certainly be a better school than we were last year. Improvement, learning, it's at the heart of what we should be doing each and every day. So boys, as we go past the halfway mark of this premiership quarter, we're now in week 6. I urge you to maintain your commitment. I urge you to maintain your resilience. I urge you to retain your persistence in front of whatever difficulty you might be encountering at here or beyond school as well. Right, because that's at the essence. And I particularly give a message out to our year 12s on the back of a chorus and now a couple of weeks ago as we lead in to those mock exams in a couple of weeks' time. Boys, you need to be extra committed. You need to be particularly persistent and you need to be resilient as we gear up to those final exams. The year 12s particularly need to be taking on those opportunities and support that our teachers are giving them each and every day. Boys, again, congratulations to our award winners. Can I say thanks, and I should have said this earlier on, thanks and to Mr. Mara for his fine words, his reflections upon Mary McKillop this morning. And I did want to acknowledge our teachers who are awarded as well. Congratulations to them, and I thank them for their great service to this school, but also to Catholic education more broadly. Thanks, folks. Have a great day.
Good morning, Mr. Fulliger, parents, online viewers, and of course, men of Nudgee. Last week, the whole boarding village, for the first time in a very long time, sat for dinner in the same room. Although it was for many a new experience, for one boarding house, it wasn't. And that was Hora. For the first time, Hora introduced Christmas in July to the rest of the dorms. Let's talk about the history. You see, this was a remarkable event organized for Hora by our beloved and late Julie Kopetke. What was once a Hora tradition was now experienced by the entire Bathersby boarding. Christmas in July for Hora meant a variety of things. The fact that you could sit with your best mates, but also connect with staff, friends, and family. As we reflect on fun times of our stay in boarding, but also on times and moments of when we overcame hardship, moments of hardship, this is all done over a meal and, of course, a laugh or two. And I know I speak for everyone that attended that it was truly an enjoyable night. It goes to show how genuine the environment can get and how comforting and talented everyone is. Nevertheless, an all-rounding, entertaining night from each dorms, with Vuli leading the quarter dorm with a Taylor Swift TikTok, from Isaac singing and Andrew featuring with a rap. Courageous act for Miles to get up and sing in front of all the dorms. It took guts, and we thank him for that. It wasn't an easy thing to do. And last but not least, Sam, for dedicating his performance to the loved Julie Kopetke. We're lucky to see Sam perform that again today. As we keep Julie in our hearts, we look forward to many more Christmas in July with the boys. And thank you to Lee Chewy Clark for creating a short video we're about to watch. Join me in congratulating everyone. Thank you for listening.
She'll be with us forever, so we all love you, Julie.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, blowing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong.
Well done to Sam for sharing that, preparing that, and that is a precious gift that he has shared with us today. Thank you also to Lastus and everybody involved in that presentation about our boarding house, and most particularly for the formal dinner itself, the Christmas in July. A special tribute to Julie there as well. Ladies and gentlemen, in very much in the line of College Assembly these days, being a little bit like its own television production, I welcome to the stage to talk about what's been going on in an old-fashioned sports show sense, in this term sports. I welcome to the stage Ben McMillan, the Sindhu, Bailey, Lastus and Declan, and they're about to come up on stage. My mind goes back to Saturday and Sunday morning sports shows. With Ben, our host today, we look forward to hearing all about the seasons. Can we welcome our sports captains to the stage?
Good morning. Today I am with the four captains of sport for this term three, which has been like no other. So I'll be doing a quick Q&A asking a few questions regarding COVID and how it's impacted their season so far. So Lass and Thass, what have been the impacts of COVID and how have we adapted?
It's great. Great question, Ben. Thass, you want to go first?
In our season, we had a really short preparation, you know, and yeah, that's about it. And then the crowd restrictions, we haven't been able to feed off the crowd's energy in our game, so that's been a major impact for us. I think that's about it.
Yeah, same with Thass. COVID definitely had an impact on our preseason. A couple of boys, we all had to train like individual and stuff, so it was a slow start to rugby season. But yeah, like Thess said, we needed the crowd out there.
Is there anything your coaches have done to try and help with that?
Thess?
We've had a lot of mini basketball camps, so all the credit goes to the coaches and stuff. And throughout the holidays, we've had a lot of training sessions, so that's been really helpful for the first basketball team. So that's about it.
Yeah, we just had little mini groups, I guess, like groups of four, just training and stuff. But as restrictions got lifted, we all came back and did it.
Okay, thank you. So to Declan and Bailey, how are the teams traveling midway through the competition so far?
Yeah, so at the moment, we're in the middle of the table. We're coming fourth at the moment. We've had some up and downs. We've won some hard games. We've also lost a few here and there. But, yeah, we're traveling all right at the moment.
Yeah, same. We're coming fourth right now. We've won two, had a tie because of rain out, and we've had two close losses. But, yeah, we're doing well.
So, also, are there any changes that need to be made for the rest of the competition?
Yeah, so, of course, there's always room for improvement. We just have to lift our intensity and just be more driven than ever to hopefully get a result at the end of the season.
Not really. We've got one of the youngest teams we've had for a long time, and I think with time and practice, we should be a really strong team next year.
That's great. So this is to all of you now. Any standout athletes, teams, or performances so far in your respected sports?
Yeah, so across soccer, there's numerous undefeated teams and teams that are looking to win the premiership, so shout out to some of them. I know 6As, 9As, 10As, and I think 11As as well, all undefeated and doing really well.
Paddy Townsend, MacArthur Swain, Lawson, Zane Kremer, Luke Doig, and Isaac Michaels are all undefeated this term, and keep it up.
Yeah, for us would be probably under-15s, under-15As and under-12s. They've been going really good so far, so yeah.
Shout out to Rocco Bolton in year 5. He's been playing really well. and to 90s. I would like to congratulate them on their undefeated season. And to Josh Clark in the first, he's been huge for us in the defensive end, blocking shots, rebounding. So congratulations.
So for leadership, Lastis and Thass, do you have any advice for young captains in the program?
I would say it starts in training. Like, you gotta encourage your teammates, hold each other accountable in training sessions. That's about it, I think.
I'd probably say, I guess you gotta enjoy more of like the hard times as well, because it's easy to enjoy like easy times. So say if it's in a game you're winning by 50, it's easy to enjoy those games. But also when you enjoy your tough games, when you're down by like 5, you know, just keep enjoying it.
Keep pushing them. And then also this year we came together, all sport captains and sport leaders, and created a vision for this 2020 season. It hasn't gone to plan, but how do you think the sport is living the vision we've made for this year in tennis and soccer?
Yeah, so obviously we want to be competitive, but it's also important to stay respectful, and I think that's more evident now than ever. You know, we're having the lowest amount of red cards we've had before, and, you know, every single game, from game to game, we're trying to be a good sportsman and, you know, live up those Nudgee values.
Whenever we have training or on game days, if you're in the first or in the year 10s or anything, we're constantly cheering each other on, no matter if you're in the A's or the D's. And we've become like one big community, one big family. And
That's it for questions. But, you know, keep supporting the athletes. And even though we can't be out to the games, keep an eye on what's happening. And follow Bill Ingham Myers on Bear on Air, which normally comes out on the Wednesdays and is sent out to the school. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you to Mr. Kennellan for facilitating that, and for our captains for their performance there up on stage. Just a couple of final things for us to be aware of across the college now, and some well done's to finish as well. So, of course, gentlemen, we know halfway through this term, across grades now, many assessment items are due in. So it's certainly in that championship quarter that Mr. Fulliger talks about. We're really in the hot zone of that championship quarter. So across all of the things that we have on here at Nudgee, our studies is an absolute focus for us. And I know that across grades we have many things due over coming weeks. Well done to the boys who have put their hand up in their houses to be involved in inter-house debating. And I know that is coming to its conclusion. And I think there is a big event on tomorrow, perhaps in Teeny Hall. So boys, make sure that you're supporting your house in inter-house debating. And particularly well done to boys who have had the courage to put their hand up for that. Over recent weeks, we've returned somewhat to normal for house assemblies, and they are advertised up there on the screen for you to have a look at. Boys in year 7 going into 8, boys in 8 going into 9, 9 into 10, and 10 to 11, you have some choices that you now have to make in terms of your subjects. And either deadlines have just passed, or the deadlines will be in the next 2 days for you to choose next year's subjects. Congratulations to the boys who are in year 9 on their set plan interviews yesterday, and for boys in year 10 for their set plan interviews last week. Boys sat with a staff member, an academic mentor, to talk about their subjects that they are doing and what they want to do in the future. Congratulations to Mr. Sepp and his team for organising that wonderful program. Boys, now is time for you to choose those subjects. So that is really important that you are having conversations with mum and dad at night over the dinner table about where you are heading, with teachers in your subjects at the moment, and then to actually get online and fill that out. Mr. Johnson and Mr. Steele will spend a heck of a lot of time making sure our timetable is right for next year, if we've got the right amount of teachers for the subjects that you want to do. So that information is really important. Well done again to the 9s and 10s, but boys, from grade 7 to 10, if you can make your subject selection now an absolute priority, please, over the next couple of days. To the college community, I wanted to give a well done today to a number of people connected with the Year 11 semi-formal. Firstly, to Miss Larissa Patty and Miss Tonya Scholes from the student office for organising and facilitating that event, along with Mr. Raoul Carmody and his team. And at the same time as they were organising that event, you saw that we were hosting the boarding Christmas in July dinner as well. So there's a lot on at once for those good people. Gentlemen, can we congratulate those people for their efforts that went into those events? I'd like to congratulate the Year 11s as well on the way they looked after their partners at the event, and they engaged so beautifully in a COVID-safe semi-formal last week. College community, the brief from Mr. Fulliger to the college leadership team is really clear. If we can possibly have milestone events for boys that we have each year, and if we can do them in a COVID-safe way, we are to persevere, regardless of the difficulty in having those events. We are committed to putting on events for you if we possibly can. And we've seen that in sport and performing arts and boarding as well. And last week's Year 11 semi-formal was no exception. But gentlemen, we had to have a semi-formal in which we couldn't have dancing. And I know that excites some people, but many others it doesn't. There could be no dancing, and we had to be seated for the absolute vast majority of the night. And the grade 11s engaged in that fantastically well. To fill the space, we had different entertainers. We had magicians, we had jugglers, we had singers, we had Year 11 performances, and it was a wonderful night. Ladies and gentlemen, can we congratulate the Year 11s for their semi-formal? And Year 12s, don't worry, we are going to make sure that your formal coming up on September the 20th is extra special as well, with perhaps some similar acts and some extra ones as well to make that extra special. Congratulations to our junior school boys who recently involved themselves in the BFF campaign by walking 100 kilometres during lunchtime. Now, obviously, gentlemen, it wasn't one boy that walked 100 kilometres, but around 100 plus Nudgee men all played their part in walking that 100 kilometres. Can I congratulate the Year 7s on their Galilee Day, which is in its own way a milestone retreat for boys who have entered high school at Nudgee. Gentlemen, so many things to be thankful for here at Nudgee, and so many things to celebrate. With that in mind, today I ask to jump up to lead us in three cheers. Proud Year 9 man, Roman DeClara.
No, Nudgee! Three cheers for St. Mary Feast Day, Australia's only saint. Three cheers for all long-serving staff. Three cheers to all Principal Award winners. Keep up the good work, boys. Three cheers to Sam's moving performance. May we always remember Julie. Three cheers to all Into House debaters. Three cheers to all first teams and all other sports teams. Keep up the good work. And congratulations to the Year 11s on a good formal. Let's make this one loud, boys. Ingoi! Ingoi! Ingoi!
Thanks, Roman. In a moment, ladies and gentlemen, we are head off just a touch early, which is great, a touch early for period two. Mums and dads, if you are here and would like a photograph with your son who has just received an award, thank you. Mums and dads, if you are here and would like a photograph with your son, that is great. I would ask all year nine winners of the Principal's Award if you can stay back for a photograph with Mr. Sepp, please. And gentlemen, let's conclude today by being upstanding for the college song.
Beneath our vibrant spirit, beyond our victory, between our pride and glory, we are a sign of faith. There's a love I do not know, but the sounds and furies call. Great honor, great glory, great voice and great song. But when sound
gentlemen, the bell will go at 9:50 in 7 minutes' time to start period two. Have a great day and a great week. Well done to all presented today.